Johnny Cochran is an American criminal trial lawyer and a civil activist. He gained international popularity with his controversial defense of several high-profile personalities. Cochran was a well-honored attorney whose skills inside the courtroom was theatrical. Johnny Lee Cochran Jr. got recognition for his legal awareness and courtroom skills. He used to solve cases involving celebrities and common men in unusual situations. Let's say, Johnny Cochran was one of the best there was at the job. Johnny was also a philanthropist. Cochran was the chairman of the Upper Manhattan Empowerment Zone. It is an organization that economically helped deprived communities. He had also set up a scholarship at the University of California under his name for African American students. Johnny Cochran was born on October 2, 1937, in Shreveport, Louisiana. Johnny Cochran was born to Johnny Cochran Sr. 1916 to 2018, and Hattie Bass Cochran. His father was an insurance salesman for Golden State Mutual Life Insurance. At the same time, his mother used to sell Avon's products. Cochran's great-grandfather was a slave. Millions of African-American families shifted to the West Coast due to the Great Migration, second phase, in 1949. Cochran's family, too, relocated to the West Coast in Los Angeles. Being an African-American during the 1950s still was a tough time. However, Johnny's family encouraged him to be independent, well-educated, and unbiased. Cochran attended public schools and excelled in his curriculums. He completed his middle school from Mount Vernon Middle School. Johnny graduated first in his class at the Los Angeles High School. He completed his BA in Business Economics from the University of California in 1959. After that, Johnny earned his Juris Doctor degree from the Loyola Law School in 1962. While in his university years, he was also a member of the Kappa Alpha Psi fraternity. Johnny was also the fraternity's 45th Laurel Wreath Laureate. Johnny Cochran married Barbara Berry Cochran in 1960. Barbara was a primary school teacher. Barbara accused Johnny of having an affair with his longtime lover, Patty Sikora. Barbara released a book titled Life After Johnny Cochran. In the book, she has opened up about domestic violence by her ex-husband, Cochran. She has written that Cochran was manipulative and offensive. She claimed that he would beat her every time she confronted him about his affair with Patty. After his divorce from Barbara, Johnny married Sylvia Dale, a sales analyst, in 1985. Cochran has three children. He has two children with Barbara named Tiffany and Melody. Johnny has a son named Jonathan with his former girlfriend, Patty. Thurgood Marshall positively influenced Johnny Cochran. He admired the legal victory he won in the Brown versus Board of Education of Topeka's case 1954. It was the case where the court ruled that U.S. state laws establishing racial segregation in public schools are constitutional, even if the segregated schools are otherwise equal in quality. This case made Cochran know what he wanted to pursue, so he decided to dedicate his life to practicing law. He felt the need and the power to make a difference by practicing law. Johnny's road to legal practice was a tough one. He studied, practiced, and also faced some setbacks as a lawyer. Nevertheless, Johnny Cochran had vowed never to stop what he was doing, so he continued striving towards his dream. Johnny is famous as the attorney of the defense team of O.J. Simpson. Simpson is an ex-football player who got charged with the murder of his ex-wife and her friend. People know Cochran for dealing with high-profile cases like Michael Jackson, Snoop Dogg, and more. He has also defended many police brutality cases associated with the African-American community. After passing the bar exam in 1963, Johnny worked as a deputy city attorney in the criminal division. His first celebrity case was of Lenny Bruce in 1964. Lenny was a comedian who had got arrested with obscenity charges. By 1966, he entered private practice and opened his own firm, Cochran, Atkins & Evans. Cochran represented an African-American widow to get justice for her husband, Leonard Deadwyler. Leonard got shot and killed by the police officers in May 1966. Even though Cochran lost the case, he realized that the trial had stirred the black community. It taught him that police brutality was an issue that really could get attention. By the late 1970s, Johnny Cochran was a well-known figure in the black community. He had already started to take several high-profile cases involving police brutality. To become one of the good guys, Cochran decided to get a pay cut and join the government. He returned to the Los Angeles County District Attorney's office. He got appointed as the first assistant district attorney. With this position, Cochran began strengthening ties with the political community. It was to change the system. After 5 years at the government office, Cochran returned to private practice, stronger. He opened the Johnny L. Cochran Jr. law firm. He won $760,000 in the case of Ron Settles, a black college football player. He got and murdered by the Signal Hill Police Department. Ron's body was found severely beaten and hanging on June 2, 1981. In 1990, Johnny Cochran joined the firm Cochran, Cherry, Givens & Smith in 1997. His Cochran firm now has regional offices in 15 states of the United States. Johnny became so powerful that he could encourage settlement on a case just by his presence. Johnny was an advocate for minorities in police brutality and civil rights cases. But the dramatic trial of the O.J. Simpson case brought him more popularity and criticism. Over the years of his career, Cochran has represented many high-profile personalities. Let's get in depth about the most talked about celebrity cases of Cochran. Cochran's most remarkable case was O.J. Simpson's case. Simpson, a former football player, got charged with the double case. The victims were his former wife, Nicole Brown Simpson, and her friend, Ron Goldman. This case brought him an international spotlight. Johnny was a part of Simpson's defense team. The team also included Robert Kardashian, Barry Sheck, Robert Shapiro, Alan Dershowitz, etc. The trial continued for 11 months, starting from January 24, 1995. During the closing arguments, O.J. Simpson was having difficulty wearing the blood-stained glove. The police found it at the crime scene. It was when Cochran uttered, "If it doesn't fit, you must acquit." He denoted that Simpson was not guilty of the double murder case. In October 1995, the authorities found Simpson found not guilty of the crime. Prosecutor Christopher Darden suggested that Cochran had tampered with the glove. He also accused Cochran of persuading the juror of a considerable doubt on the DNA evidence. According to Mercury.com, Cochran made $5 million to defend O.J. Simpson. Rumors have it that O.J. Simpson never really fully paid any of the Dream Team's lawyers. According to Schiller's book, American Tragedy, Shapiro was more of a plea bargain lawyer. He wanted O.J. to plea bargain, to which O.J. denied. Shapiro had doubts that O.J. may have committed the crime even though he was adamant that he was innocent. Shapiro brought Cochran and Bailey to the team. Both believed that O.J. was innocent. Later, Cochran led the Dream Team. Shapiro fell out with Bailey. Bailey accused Shapiro of leaking information. Robert Shapiro was not willing to win at all costs as much as Cochran and Bailey did. Meanwhile, Cochran wanted to use the race card. He tried to put it into lap to frame O.J. because he was black, to which Shapiro disagreed. So, Shapiro separated himself from the Dream Team. Another famous high-profile case won by Johnny was Sean Combs, P. Diddy, in 2001. Sean got charged with bribery and stolen weapons. Cochran defended him and won Combs' freedom. Cochran retired after his trial in 2002. R. Kelly and Allen Iverson also sought him out, but he declined. Another famous case that Cochran has been a part of is of Abner Louima. Abner Louima was a Haitian man living in Brooklyn. An officer, Justin Volpe, of the New York City Police Department, NYPD, had assaulted, brutalized, and sexually abused him. Abner got $8.75 million for settlement, the largest police brutality settlement in NYC. Stanley Tookie Williams was a 17-year-old kid at that time. He was a founder and leader of an African-American street gang in Los Angeles called Crisps. Stanley got charged with robbery in early 1997. Johnny Cochran helped him get acquitted of all charges in a matter of 10 minutes. Later, Stanley Tookie Williams was yet again charged for assaulting an APD personnel. Cochran denied representing Williams for his multiple murder trials. Geronimo Pratt is a military charged with the abduction and murder of an elementary school teacher. Pratt had served 27 years in prison. People considered his release in 1997 Cochran's happiest day of his legal practice. After the O.J. Simpson trial, Johnny became a commentator for law-related shows. He even hosted his show named Johnny Cochran Tonight that aired on Court TV. There were deals from Hollywood, too. He appeared in sitcoms like The Huglies, Family Matters, and many more. At a time, Cochran had become a parody topic. It was when actor Phil Morris played attorney Jackie Chiles, representing Cochran in Seinfeld. South Park also satirized him. The cast portrayed Cochran using the legal strategy called the Chewbacca defense. Ving Rhames has portrayed Cochran in the miniseries called American Tragedy, 2000. The Book of Mormon had also mentioned Johnny. It is a musical comedy that depicts Cochran being in hell for setting O.J. Simpson free. Actor Courtney B. Vance also portrayed Cochran in The People vs. O.J. Simpson, American Crime Story, 2016. The actor won the Primetime Emmy Award for Outstanding Lead Actor in a Limited Series or Movie. Johnny also attended many TV programs like Jimmy Kimmel Live, The Chris Rock Show, etc. Cochran has written two books, namely Journey to Justice, 1996, and A Lawyer's Life, 2012. Some sources also granted $2.5 million to write his memoir. Thus, Johnny was very successful. He was able to establish his enterprise, write his books, have his show, and even act on sitcoms. Cochran had the best of all. People recognized Johnny nationally for his high-profile cases. People praised him for his dedication to bringing justice to everyday Americans. A list of his rewards and recognitions are as follows. The first attorney in LA to receive both Civil Trial Lawyer of the Year and Criminal Trial of the Year awards. The National Law Journal's America's Trial Lawyer of the Year in 1995. Times Headliners of the Year in 1999. Top 50 Trial Attorneys of 1999 in Los Angeles Business Journal. Elected as a member of the Inner Circle of Advocates. Recognized as one of the top 1% of trial lawyers in the United States. Inducted into the prestigious International Academy of Trial Lawyers. Cochran's career as a go-to lawyer earned him great wealth. He owned cars such as Rolls-Royce and Jaguar. He also had several homes in Los Angeles, two apartments in West Hollywood, and a Manhattan condo. Johnny Cochran's net worth before his death was around $8 million. Cochran's accountant estimated that his net worth would have been $25 to $50 million within 2021 if he were alive. Johnny is a well-known philanthropist as well. He is the chairman of the Upper Manhattan Empowerment Zone. It is a publicly funded organization that sought economic developments for various neighborhoods. He also established the Johnny L. Cochran Jr. Scholarship for African American Men at UCLA. He had also established the Johnny L. Cochran Jr. Soaring Eagle Award in 1997. It is awarded to an attorney who pursues excellence. An attorney who has made considerable contributions to the legal profession while inspiring others. Johnny does not own any form of social media account since he passed away in 2005. You can find his school and university websites that have his scholarship information. Johnny Lee got diagnosed with a brain tumor in December 2003. He underwent surgery in April 2004 due to which he remained away from the media. Sometime after his surgery, he announced that he was feeling good and was in good health. Sadly, Johnny Cochran passed away on March 29, 2005, at his home in Los Angeles. A public viewing of his casket took place on April 4 at the Angeles Funeral Home. The viewing also took place at the Second Baptist Church, Los Angeles, on April 5. His family held a memorial service at the West Angeles Church of God in Christ on April 6. His remains were buried in Inglewood Park Cemetery in Inglewood, California. His father and many friends attended Johnny's funeral. Former clients, including O.J. Simpson and Michael Jackson, were also there. Johnny Cochran was aged 67 when he died. Johnny had successfully influenced so many lives and inspired people. His legacy continues to date. Los Angeles Unified School District approved renaming Mount Vernon Middle School to Johnny L. Cochran Jr. Middle School in his honor. The school was where Cochran once studied. In 2007, the authorities renamed three blocks in front of the school as the Johnny Cochran Vista. Cedars-Sinai Medical Center launched Johnny L. Cochran Jr. Brain Tumor Center in 2007. Cochran's neurosurgeon, Keith Black, led the research center. Cochran's family created the Johnny L. Cochran Jr. Chair in Civil Rights at his alma mater. They placed it at the Loyola Law School of Loyola Marymount University. His footprints also got featured on Northwest Louisiana Walk of Stars. If there is anything you'd like to add or think we've missed, please feel free to comment below.